Hey guys, Abby here, and welcome to part one of my anointed gear guide. This video is going to help you sort through all your anointed shields and grenades to find the best anointments for your build. I'll also be sharing with you my own tier rankings based on my own personal experience. And if your damage numbers look like this right now, don't worry, because by the end of this video, they're going to be looking like this. Anointed items in Borderlands 3 provide the player with an additional perk on their weapon or gear. This is seen at the bottom of the item card highlighted here. These anointed perks are either specific to a Vault Hunter or general for every character to use. You can differentiate anointed items on the ground by the additional glow and animation of the loot marker. Anointed items can be any rarity on a weapon, shield, or grenade. To get anointed items, you only have to play the game. You'll start to see more and more anointed items drop as you progress through the story. In True Vault Hunter mode, your second playthrough, anointed drops will increase, as well as when you go up in Mayhem tiers. Another way to get anointed items is from Earl's vending machine downstairs in Sanctuary. These refresh each time you load up the game, and they cost Iridium. So if you're leveling up or new to endgame, this is a great way to pick up anointed items to get you started. Once you've hit endgame, make sure to also check the vending machines as you travel around Borderlands. I've found many of my favorite anointed grenades in Marcus's ammo machines. Alright, now that you know where to find the gear, let's answer some quick questions about how anointments work. If you're using an anointed weapon, the perk applies to that weapon only, and the weapon must be out for the anointment to be active. So you can see here, I wasn't doing any radiation damage before my action skill. I used my action skill, and now I'm doing radiation damage with the companion pistol. If you're using an anointed shield or grenade, that anointment will apply no matter what weapon you're using. Also, if the anointment specifies a certain Vault Hunter class, Siren, Beastmaster, Gunner, or Operative, you must be playing that class for the anointment to proc. Two of the same anointed perks will not stack. However, you can stack different anointed perks from your grenade, shield, and your currently equipped weapon. Anointed items are extremely valuable in Borderlands at endgame. You can use them to improve your damage, sustainability, and action skill uptime. It's important to create synergy between the anointed items you use. I'm going to give you a specific example that's extremely meta right now for Vault Hunters that have quick action skill cooldown rates, like my Rack Attack Flak here. Using the anointments on your shield and grenade that say on action skill end, gain 50% bonus elemental damage with weapons for 10 seconds. That element can be corrosive, incendiary, shock, cryo, or radiation. So what you want to do is pair one of these with another one on your grenade, but have it be a different element. So for example, we've got radiation on our recurring hex, we've got corrosive on our transformer shield, and we're going to be using the ion laser here, which has on the next two magazines bonus cryo damage. Now this also stacks with our shield and our grenade, plus the weapon's going to be doing fire damage, as you can see there in the bottom right. So after we throw our rack attacks, we should be getting cryo, fire, corrosive, and radiation. So before we throw our racks, when we shoot at the target, we're only getting fire damage. And now we throw our racks, and then afterwards we're going to be getting a ton of numbers. So let's go in close with the photo mode. I'll show you guys. You can see incendiary, cryo, radiation, and corrosive. So this is how you start to do massive damage. So keep these synergies in mind when you're evaluating your items. Now finally, the tier rankings for anointed grenades and shields. Let me first preface this by saying these are my rankings and my opinions based on personal experience and what I've seen others use as well. There will always be an ebb and flow of the rankings as new anointed gear enters the loot pool. Using any anointed item over a non-anointed item is always preferable, especially on grenades and shields. I also did not include Terra anointed gear in this ranking since the Bloody Harvest event is over and that gear cannot be acquired until next year. As you guys may be familiar with, S tier is our top best anointments to use for most, if not all, builds across all Vault Hunters, and then the ranking goes down from there. I also ranked certain anoints lower because they require specific builds for them to really shine. All right guys, first we're gonna take a look at anointed grenades. So here is the ranking list if you wanna screenshot it or whatever, but I'm gonna leave a link down in the description below where you can find this. First up, coming in at S tier is on action skill end, gain 50% elemental damage with weapons for 10 seconds. This comes in every single element. It comes in radiation, corrosive, shock, fire, cryo, everything. So this is an S tier anointment. This is amazing to have on any character, but it really, really shines on characters where you're using an action skill with a quick cooldown. So you're going to want to trigger that action skill end as much as you can so that you can get the 50% elemental bonus on all of your weapons. The next one is coming in at A tier is on grenade thrown, weapon grenade and action skill damage are increased by 25% for 6 seconds. This is a short time. If you have a way to regen grenades like on Moe's, this can be really great. This is also really great for Zane because his action skills can have a really long duration, so you may not be triggering action skill end as much as some of the other builds. This is also really good on Gamma Burst Flak because Gamma Burst lasts longer. This is also a really good anointment just for getting burst damage if you need to throw a grenade at a target just to get that increase of 25% weapon damage for a short amount of time. It's really great for that as well. And then next down at the B tier, we have on action skill start, regenerate one grenade. This is kind of your basic starter intro to grenade anointed items. It is really good in early game. If you don't have anything else, this is great. However, like I said before, I would recommend checking out vending machines, trying to find those elemental anointments or the weapon grenade and action skill anointment. And then in the bottom, I don't think it's terrible, but there's definitely better anointments as you guys have seen. But this is a Moe's specific anointment. While Iron Bear is active, taking damage has a 20% chance to spawn a grenade each 8 seconds. If you're going to be in your Iron Bear a lot, then this could potentially be a fairly good one. But I feel like the other ones are going to serve you better in terms of damage. So that's why it's down here. And that's it for the anointed grenades. Pretty simple, not too many of them. You're going to want to go with one of the top two if you can. Like I said earlier, it can be beneficial just to grab one of these out of the vending machine, even if it's a blue or a green or whatever, just to get you started because it is going to impact all of your weapons since you're using the anointed item on your grenade. All right, let's head over to the shield tiers. This is the anointed shield tier ranking. We've got a lot of them. Of course, you're going to want to make sure it's a shield that you want to use. It's a good shield and it works with your build. But that being said, overall, again, in S tier, we're going to find on action skill end gains 50% elemental damage with weapons for 10 seconds. Again, this comes in every single element, so you're going to want to collect all of them. And this is definitely S tier. It is super S tier, S plus tier, if you pair this with a grenade with the same anointment but different element, like I was demonstrating earlier. And then let's go down to A tier. We'll do the specific Vault Hunter ones after this. But if we go down to A tier, we've got on action skill and action skill cooldown rate is increased by 20% for 15 seconds. And I will make note here, you guys, I took this from a data mined list of anointments. Most of these, if not all, I've acquired in the game, so I know it's possible. However, the anointments do not mention the exact seconds, so that has been data mined, so I can't speak on the validity of that, but I feel pretty good putting it on this sheet to kind of give you guys an idea of what a short time means for these anoints. So on action skill end, action skill cooldown rate is increased by 20% for 15 seconds. This one is really great for those action skills that have a little bit longer of a cooldown rate. So we're looking at Iron Bear, we're looking at Gamma Burst and things like that. We also have on action skill and regenerate 5% max health per second for 12 seconds. This is really great for Flak because Flak does not really have a lot of sustainability right now. So this could be great to incorporate in a build, or if you don't have an anointment currently on your shield, then this is a great one for that sustainability. So moving down here to the C tier, we've got on action skill and melee damage is increased by 100% for 12 seconds. I put this one down here because it really is just for melee builds only. You're going to be using it on melee specific builds, if you're using the face puncher, if you are specking into melee damage. So while it can be a really good anointment, I feel like other ones kind of surpass it overall. But if you are making a melee specific build, this could be a good option. Then down in the D tier, we've got on action skill and movement speed is increased by 5% for 12 seconds, which could be good on Zane because Zane does more damage when he's moving faster if you spec into those skills. However, Zane has specific anointments that are better than this general one, but it's a nice anointment to have. It's not bad. It's just not very good. And then going down to the E tier, we've got on action skill end, damage taken is reduced by 13% for 12 seconds. This one, I just don't really think is that good. It doesn't really add that much. 13% out of a massive rocket damage is not going to be that much that it's reducing. It's only for 12 seconds. Unless you have a really quick action skill, I just don't see this being worth it. Even if you do, I feel like there are a lot of other anointed shields that you could go with over this one. So that's why I put that so low. And those are all of the general anointments that you can get on your shields. So now we're going to take a look at the specific Vault Hunter ones. So the ones in yellow here are Zane, the ones in blue are Moz, the ones in purple are Amara, and the ones in white are Flak. So up at S tier, these two anointments for your shields are the ones that I've seen the most in other people's builds, the ones that I've used the most in my builds for these characters. So I put them up at the top. We've got while Sentinel is active, move speed is increased by 15%. Zane has skills you can spec into where you gain increased damage based on your movement speed. And so this anointment in particular translates over to damage if you spec into those skills. So this is a great synergy with that. It works really well with his skills, and it's a really great anointment to have, especially because right now you can spec into skills with Zane where your action skills are lasting for a long time. So it doesn't really make sense to use a lot of the action skill end anointments. And this one is active the entire time while Sentinel is active. So you're basically getting a 15% buff forever. Next up here on the S tier is one for Moz. After exiting Iron Bear, gain 75% increased shields and health for 25 seconds. This is a great sustain one. Moz is another one that has a fairly long action skill, not as long as some of the others. However, it is kind of a burden to get in and out of the Iron Bear constantly. So instead of using those action skill end anointments, some people prefer to use this one because it gives you a lot of sustainability. After you exit Iron Bear, you're getting increased shields and health, so it helps a lot in the higher Mayhem tiers. So next we go down to the A tier for the specific Vault Hunters. We've got another one here for Moz. This is after exiting Iron Bear, kills increase Iron Bear's cooldown rate by 30% for 30 seconds. This one's really great if you're focusing on Iron Bear and you want the cooldown. Moz also has some skills that will increase the cooldown rate of Iron Bear, but this is a great one to have if you don't want to spec into some of those skills. I would say that this anointment is more of an A plus kind of. It could be really good as an option for Moz for an Iron Bear build. So then we go down to the B tier. We're looking at two Zane skills in here. When barrier is deployed, instantly start recharging your shields. And while Digiclone is active, regenerate 3% max health per second. Both of these are great for sustainability. So if you are needing sustainability and not damage and you're looking to go that route, these are really good. Also keep in mind, a lot of times I prioritize damage anointments over sustainability. So depending on your playstyle, you may kind of bump these up in tears in your own mind, but that's just how I look at things. I feel like if the things are dead, then there's your sustainability. So down in tier C, we've got one for Amara here. We've got, after using Phase Slam, melee damage is increased by 200% for 10 seconds. I put this one in here at the same level as the general melee one. So obviously, if you're playing Amara, you would want to prioritize getting this anointment over the regular action skill and melee damage one, if you're doing a melee build. So you really don't want to use this if you're not doing a melee build, obviously, but if you are doing a melee build and you are on Amara, which is the melee character pretty much, you're going to want to use this anointment. It can be good, but it is required to have a build based around it, so I put it down here at C. So now we're going to jump down to E. This is where it gets kind of bad. We're going to start out with Flax anointment down here. When exiting fadeaway, create a Nova that deals 175% of your damage. You will see a number instead of that 175%. So it scales based on your own damage. This is an all right anointment, but there are so many that provide more damage and just that are way better for Flak fadeaway. Fadeaway is a quick action skill, so you're going to be triggering that action skill end a lot. So any of the other anointments that give you damage are going to be better than this one. And then also in the E tier, we've got one for Amara. While Phase Grasp is active, Amara constantly triggers Novas that deal 50% damage for 15 seconds. This one is all right, but you're really only going to see this one become S tier if you use the Frozen Heart Shield. If you guys have seen Moxie's video, he goes over basically how to trigger this anointed Nova and the shield Nova at the same time constantly. When you pair those two together, it can be an S tier anointment, but when they're not paired together, the Frozen Heart Shield and this anointment really isn't that good compared to all the other ones that you could be getting on your shield. And then we've got another Moe's one. When entering and exiting Iron Bear, create a Nova that deals 175% damage. I feel like this one is kind of like meh. It can be kind of nice to have the Nova, but it's not going to be doing that much damage. And I don't think you're going to be putting your Iron Bear in the middle of a gajillion enemies, especially at higher mayhem tiers, because it's just going to get melted immediately. However, at lower levels, this one can be kind of useful. All right, now let's take it down to F tier. This is basically the anointments that you don't really want to even keep. The first one is for Flak. After using attack command, gain 8% movement speed for 6 seconds. This is like a nice quality of life thing, I guess, if you want to throw it on, but it's not going to really give you much sustainability or damage or anything like that. Plus, using the attack command on Flak is kind of annoying and kind of takes away from your damage because you're having to target an enemy and press a button and all that. So to use the attack command on cooldown is very rare. So it will be very rare that you would get this 8% movement speed, and it only lasts 6 seconds, so I really don't think this is worth it at all. The next one is grants an extra charge of rack attack. This one's for Flak also. This one is a complete piece of garbage anointment. Don't even bother keeping it on your shield. As a matter of fact, I believe it's broken on the shield. I don't know if it exactly works correctly. It seems like sometimes when you equip the shield, it's working, and sometimes it's not. You may have to re-equip it to get it to start working, so I would just stay away from this one altogether. The cooldown rate on Rack Attack is pretty good as it is, so you don't really need an extra one. Next in the F tier, we've got another one for Amara. On action skill end, 30% of all damage taken is returned to the attacker for 12 seconds. It sounds good in theory, and it's kind of odd that this is a Siren-specific anointment. When I first read this, I thought it was for everybody, but turns out it's just for Amara. But I just don't think reflection damage is really that great in Borderlands 3. You get a portion of the enemy's damage done to you returned back to them, and the disparity between the damage they're doing and the health they have is pretty great, so it doesn't really make that much of a difference, I'd say. So I feel like this is down here at the F tier. And then we also have, after using Phase Slam, damage taken is reduced by 25% and move speed is increased by 12% for 12 seconds. This could help some of the damage for Amara because of the move speed. However, I just feel like there are so many better anointments out there for shields, so that's why I put this down into the F tier. Plus, we have that damage taken is reduced. It could help with some sustainability, but I just don't ever see it being used. I don't think it's a very good annoyment overall. All right, guys, so that's my tier rankings for grenades and shields in Borderlands 3 for the current annoyments that are out there in the game. Of course, as I add new ones, I'm going to update you guys with a new tier list. I'll be leaving a link in the description below where you guys can find the Imgur links for both of these tier rankings if you want to check them out. Let me know your thoughts because I'm curious. I want to know. I just did these rankings myself. I didn't really consult anybody other than watching other YouTube videos. So let me know if you would change anything, if you would bump any up, bump any down, and maybe we'll make edits as we go along. And this could be like a community driven tier ranking for anointments to help other people in the game when they're looking at what gear to keep, what gear to give up, and trying to create a build that synergizes with the anointments that they have. All right, guys, that's it for the anointed items guide for shields and grenades. Part 2 is coming soon for weapons, so keep an eye out on my channel for that one. If you enjoy Borderlands 3 content and you want to see more, hit that subscribe button, ring the bell for notifications. I also stream on twitch.tv/abbyhour Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern time if you want to come by and say hi. And that's all for now. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.